Hello and welcome to another episode of Tableau in 2 minutes. Today we're demonstrating level of detail calculations. In a prior video we went through the fixed level of detail calculations. In this video we're going to be using the exclude level of detail calculations, and we're all going to contain them in the same workbook, and you'll be able to download that workbook so you can see exactly how they're done. And there's a link to the data in the video description. What we're using today is the Superstore sales data that is available from Tableau's website. So, fixed level of detail calculations, just to review, calculate the sum of a measure at a fixed level of detail. In this case, we'll be using the product category. Now, if we create this same table, so we'll drag out product category onto our rows shelf, product subcategory onto the rows shelf, and then we'll drag out sales onto our ABCs here to create the same table, then what we have is an opportunity to do the same thing, but in a slightly different way. So a fixed level of detail calculation always calculates at the product category level. An exclude level of detail calculation will exclude something that is in our viz from the calculation. So in this case, if we excluded product subcategory, then we would be calculating at the product category level. So we'll go ahead and do that. We're going to create an exclude subcategory. Right, then we're going to open up our level of detail calculation here. We're going to say sum of sales. All right, and then we're going to hit OK. We're going to take this exclude subcategory, drag it out here. Oh, I think we might have made an error. We forgot to put in the category, so we're going to say exclude product subcategory. And now we're going to exclude the product subcategory from our viz right now. So now you can see that the numbers are the same because we weren't excluding anything. But if we hit apply, you'll see that now we're calculating at the product category level because we're excluding this product subcategory. So this, again, is sales. We could divide these two and we could get the percent of sales by product subcategory. What happens now though that's a little bit different than what happened before is that if we take province and we drag province out in between the two here, you'll see that we're now getting the sum of all of the furniture sold in Alberta excluding the product subcategory. So this has actually changed. If you remember when we did this with fixed level of detail calculations, we were still getting the sum for the entire furniture category. Now we're just getting it for furniture sold in Alberta. So we're still excluding this particular product subcategory, but we're not always calculating at a fixed level. Again, this is helpful. It's going to allow us to, if we wanted to, we could divide sales by this product subcategory and we could get the percent of sales for that particular product category in province. Or if we wanted to add anything else to the view, it would continue to only exclude that subcategory. So if you have questions, please leave them in the comments. As I said, the data is in the video description, and stick around for our next video coming up on the include level of detail calculations.